Hello everyone, and welcome. If you are new to my channel, my name is Robin, and today we are going to make a Celtic cross granny square, or Celtic cross granny square, whichever way you pronounce it. I am using Yarn Bee Soft Secret. This one is an avocado. I'm going to do one in olive and a 5mm crochet hook. The square is an eight rounds to complete. Not sure what I wanted to say there. And it makes about a 7.5 inch square with the 5mm hook. Of course, you can use whatever yarn and hook size that you would like. So, let's just get started. Okay, so we're going to start off with chaining 6. So, of course, you make your slip knot however way you do it. And chain 6. And 6. And slip stitch it into the first chain on that to form a ring. Now I'm going to chain 2. This doesn't count as anything. It just raises my work up to the next level. And we're going to do 16 double crochets into the circle. 16. So, one, two, three, okay, once you get to 16, you are going to slip stitch into your first double crochet, not our chain 2, but this one up here, the first double crochet, and make a slip stitch. That was round 1. Round 2, we are going to chain 3. That will count as your first double crochet. And we're going to do 2 more double crochets in the same stitch. 1 and 2. And then we're going to chain 2. We're going to skip this stitch. And in the next one, we're going to put a double crochet. And we're going to chain 2. Skip this stitch and come over to the next one, and we're going to put 3 double crochets. And then we're chaining 2, skipping this stitch, coming to the next one, and do a double crochet. Chain 2, skip the stitch, come over to the next one, and do 3 double crochets. So you would follow this pattern all the way around your circle. You should end up with 4 sections of the 3 double crochets. So 1, 2, 3. Trying to pick up both loops. There we go. Okay. So that was round 2. Round 3. We are going to chain 3. And we are going to do 5 double crochets in the next double crochet. So not where we chained up, but five in here. The next one, all in the same space. It's one, two, three, four, and five. And then we're going to do one double crochet into the next space. And then we chain two. And we put one double crochet over here on top of this one. And then chain two and do one double crochet in this first double crochet of the previous row, and then five into the next one. One, two, three, four, and five. One into the very next one. See, we just formed a corner there. Chain two. Double crochet on top of this one here. Chain two. Double crochet into this one. Five double crochets in the next. One. Two. Three. Four. And five, one double crochet in the next stitch, chain two, do a double crochet on top of this one, darn it, chain two, one double crochet on the first, then five in the next one. That's one, two, three, four, and five. And then one double crochet in the next space. If I could hang on to my yarn. Okay, so we're going to chain two, double crochet on top of this one, chain two again, and slip stitch in the top of the chain three. So one, two, and three. Two, three, four, five, six. So slip stitch into this, trying to catch both sides of that loop. And so we've just completed round three. So round four, you chain three. That counts as a double crochet. Sorry, I needed a drink. And then one double crochet in the next two stitches. One and two. And then five double crochets in the next. We're making another corner. It's one, two, 3, 4, and 5. And then a single double crochet in the next 3 spaces. 1, 2, and 3. We're going to chain 2. Come over here on top of that. And make a double crochet. Chain 2. And double crochet in the first 3 spaces. Five double crochets in the next space. Three, four, and 5. And then 3 double crochets in the next 3 spaces, or 1 double crochet into the next 3 spaces for a total of 3 double crochets. Chain 2. Double crochet on top of that one. Chain 2. And double crochet in the first 3 over here. And then 5 double crochets on the next one, which is our corner. Chain 2 and connect to the top of the chain 3 from the beginning of the round with a slip stitch. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. We've done 4 rounds. Then we have 4 to go. All right, so round 5, we're going to chain 3 and then do 4 double crochets, or 1 double crochet in the next 4 stitches. So 1, that actually gives us a total of 5 double crochets on this side before we reach our corner. It's 3 and 4. And then we're going to do, yep, you guessed it, 5 double crochets in the next stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And then 5 double crochets in the 1 double crochet in the next 5 stitches. One, two, three, four, and 5. So then you would chain 2 and a double crochet on top of this one. Chain 2. And then 1 double crochet in the first 5 of this corner over here. Double crochet right in that line. See how we're making a line up the middles there? Chain 2 again. And slip stitch into the top space of the chain 3 from the beginning of the round. Okay, so that was round 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, so round 6, we're going to chain 4. That counts as a double crochet and a chain one. So we're going to skip the next double crochet. And we're going to put one double crochet into the stitch after that. And then we're going to chain one. And we're going to do that three times. Skip the next stitch and then go into the one after that. Chain one, skip, and come over here. Okay, so we did it three times, technically four. So the corner spot, we are going to chain one. We're going to put a double. We're going to chain two. Whoops. And put another double in that same place. And then chain one. And in this next, very next stitch, put our double. Chain one, skip, go to the next one, put a double. Chain one, skip, go to the next one and put a double. Chain one, skip, and you should be on the last stitch in that round there, for the corner round. Oops. Splitty, splitty. Okay, and we're going to chain two. And double crochet into the top of this. And chain two again. Come over to our first double crochet. Chain one, skip, double crochet, chain one, skip, double crochet, chain one, skip, double crochet, chain one, double crochet in that corner, chain two, double crochet in that same space. Chain one. Double crochet in the first one. Chain one. Skip. Double crochet. Chain one. Skip. Double crochet. Chain one. Skip and double crochet. Chain two, double crochet on top of this one. Chain two, double crochet over to the first part, and you would complete that all the way around. Double crochet, chain one, double crochet. You do that four times, you get to the corner, and then it's double crochet, chain two, double crochet in the same space. Do it all the way around and slip stitch to the end. Okay, to finish off the round, we chain two and slip stitch into the third chain. Not the fourth. Remember, we chained four here. So one, two, three, slip stitch into the third chain from the bottom. Okay. So that was round six. Now we are on round seven. And in this one, we are going to slip stitch into our space here. And then we're going to chain up three and do one double crochet into that same space. And we're going to go to the next space and do two double crochets. And in the next one, two. And same for the next. And when you get to the corner, you're going to do three double crochets. Chain two and do three double crochets. And then two in each of these chain one spaces. And when you get to the chain two space, it is three double crochets. Okay, we're coming to the end of this round. And we're going to slip stitch into the top of our chain three to end this round. Okay, so that was round seven. And round eight is probably the easiest round of all. It is simply just a single crochet all the way around, and in the corners you do single crochet, chain two, single crochet. And that will complete your Celtic cross granny square. I don't like the way that looks. Okay, single crochet in that same space. Ah, that's better. I must have picked something up by accident. And just go all the way around and finish off your square. Okay, so when we get to the end, you know, it's slip stitch to end your row, but sometimes that slip stitch just does not look very pretty. So we're going to do a prettier way of doing that slip stitch. It just looks cleaner. Okay, so we do our last single crochet. And then we're going to pull it up through like we're fastening off. And we're going to use our yarn needle. And we're going to come over here into our very first single crochet, picking up both sides of the V and pull it through. And then come around and come down into the top part of this stitch. And it makes it look like a regular crochet stitch instead of that sloppy slip stitch that tends to throw it out of whack. And we'll just weave in our end. You know, some yarns, it shows up really wonky looking, and it just doesn't look nice. It makes it look weird. So this way makes it look nice and clean. Okay. So put these back in the bucket or the tube. Okay. So that completes our Celtic cross granny square. And, oops. See, this is what I'm saying. This one, I didn't quite finish it off yet, but if that slip stitch, it just looks funky. So I'm gonna finish this one off like I did that. Okay, so these two colors are just gorgeous together. What a nice lapghan that would make with this pattern, with that little Celtic, however you want to pronounce it, cross going through it. Just looks so fancy and elegant. Okay, well, that's all I have for you today. And I thank you for joining me on this little adventure and for watching. And I would very much appreciate it if you would leave a thumbs up and a comment down below. Just, you know, even if you just say hi. And we will see you in the next video.